Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Prescott Regional Airport, Ernest A. Love Field, is a medium-sized multi-use airport located 7 miles northeast of the city of Prescott, Arizona. Prescott is a commercial service airport and is one of the nation's top 50 busiest airports due to intensive fixed-wing and helicopter flight training. In addition, the airport supports recreational general aviation, corporate aviation, air cargo, military, and U.S. Forest Service fixed-wing and helicopter firefighting operations. This mix of pilot experience levels and aircraft capabilities makes Prescott a challenge for controllers and pilots alike. The airport configuration consists of 2 parallel runways, 3 left and right, and 21 left and right, and runway 12-30 that intersects the longer 3 right, 21 left, but not the shorter 3 left, 21 right. The taxiway system provides access to all hangars, terminals, businesses, and ramp areas that surround the airport. Pilots may fixate on the first runway they see, and in this case, the size difference makes this a likely cause of this error. Misidentifying taxiway Charlie as runway 21 right has also occurred. Expectations or confirmation bias and pilot distractions are common reasons for this mistake, but careful planning and study of the airport diagram prior to arriving will go a long way in preventing either error. At many airports, adjustments to runway safety areas have necessitated the movement of the runway hold short lines further away from the runway center line. And sometimes pilots do not expect or realize this. Aircraft exiting a runway must completely cross the runway hold lines that are protecting that runway in order to be considered clear of the runway. For example, at Prescott, when exiting runway 30 at Foxtrot 3, ensure you dash across the double dashed lines, and also hold short of taxiway Foxtrot if you can do so while being completely clear of the runway. In all cases, be aware of traffic on taxiway Foxtrot, which ground control is managing relative to your aircraft. Additionally, aircraft taxiing for departure must hold short at the double solid hold lines, which may be located further away from the runway than expected. Both of these situations may cause aircraft to encroach into the taxiway. The tower is aware of this and has planned accordingly. Hotspot 1 is an ATC non-visibility problem. Due to tower location and intervening buildings, taxiway Foxtrot 1, the hold short line on Foxtrot 1, and a portion of taxiway Foxtrot are not visible from the tower. Pilots departing runway 30 are asked to either call when they are number 1 holding short or provide their sequence number on initial contact. Hotspot 2 is a little more complex. Aircraft taxiing from the hangars located north of runway 3 left, 21 right, and instructed to taxi via Bravo 4, Bravo, have missed the right turn on Bravo 4 and the hold short line for runway 3 left at Alpha 1, entering or crossing the approach end. Understanding taxi route, including turns, crossings, and hold short instructions prior to moving the aircraft is crucial in avoiding this type of incursion. The airport diagram and moving map displays are helpful, along with keeping your eyes outside for signs and markings. Hotspot 3, located at the intersection of Charlie 4, Delta 4, and runway 3 right and 21 left, is a heavily used runway exiting location and frequent crossing point for aircraft transiting from one side of the airport to the other. Aircraft have crossed the hold short lines for the runway even after reading back the appropriate clearance. This is an example where deferring the after landing checklist, visual scanning for markings and signage, and actively listening, understanding, and executing your clearance will help avoid a hazardous mistake. And finally, as with many airports, Prescott has large areas of uncontrolled ramps and taxi lanes. These are known as non-movement areas. The rest of the airport, including the runways, taxiways, and connectors, are movement areas and controlled by the tower. When taxiing from a non-movement area, you must have the appropriate clearance before you cross the line onto the movement area. For example, pilots using the self-service fuel facility located on the north ramp should use caution to avoid accidentally entering onto taxiway Bravo 4 or taxiway Bravo without a clearance. After exiting the runway, you must have a clearance to taxi on any other movement area, including the taxiways. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Prescott will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Prescott Regional Airport, Ernest A. Love Field. It's always better to know before you go.